Welcome back, everybody. We are getting ever closer to Halloween, and I've got a lot of fun stuff to show you from my hauls in the last couple of weeks. I'm a little disappointed that last month I didn't get to do a thrift store Halloween haul video for you. I just didn't see anything worth buying in the thrift stores last month. I think as we get closer to Halloween, people are grabbing that stuff up, so it's a lot harder to find. So a little disappointed about that, and I know a lot of you have submitted your Ugly Pumpkin of the Month contenders. If you're not familiar with that, I like to showcase at least some ugly pumpkin that I found or someone of you guys have found on our shopping adventures. So I'm going to go ahead and do my honorary Ugly Pumpkin of the Month for last month now anyway. And this month's winner actually came from one of our subscribers, happens to be a patron of mine. If you're interested in becoming a patron, check out the link below. But this pumpkin was sent to us by Jared O'Lantern. Be sure to check out his page. I'll put a link to it in the description below. But this is definitely an ugly pumpkin. Something about his very bulbous face with the nose and the wart and the tongue sticking out and the crooked teeth. But I think what really kind of creeps it up just a little bit is those sunken eyes. It almost looks like there's something peering out of this jack-o'-lantern bowl. So thank you very much, Jared O'Lantern, for sending us this month, or technically last month's Ugly Pumpkin of the Month. If anyone else wants to send me an Ugly Pumpkin of the Month contender, please do so on my Instagram page at Happy Haunter. With that out of the way, let me go ahead and share with you all of the fun things I got recently. I'm gonna start with probably the biggest item. And I was kind of excited to get this because you've probably, figured out by now, if you've been watching my videos, that I'm going to be doing just a little bit of a Ghostbusters theme. I already got a Slimer inflatable. Now I have the Ecto-1 inflatable. And this is a 7-foot light-up inflatable. It's 7 feet tall. It's actually over 16 feet long. And I'm kind of excited to share this with you. We will do an unboxing and product review very soon on this so we can see what it looks like in person. So stay tuned for that. And this came from Spirit. It retailed for $250. I actually traded one of I traded a viewer for my spider archway that I got for my display last year. So I think it was kind of a good deal. I was a little sad to see my spider archway go because I really liked it, but I was planning on buying this and I was just hesitant to pay that $250. Even with a 20% discount, it's still over $200. So I was excited to get it basically for free this year. All right, gonna probably put this back on the floor because we've got a lot of stuff to show you this month. It's not all gonna fit on the table and some of it is big. But first, I will put this out on the table. I got this from Walmart. It is a Halloween table runner. And I was gonna use this in my kitchen just on the little side table just to see, or just have something, you know, on the table there. So it's a little smaller than I thought. This is 9.7 inches by 39 inches long. So you're gonna have to have a very small table. It doesn't really, I don't know if you can see that in the picture, you can see this nice drape over the side. That's not gonna happen unless you have this really small table. But this is not too bad. It's kind of good, and it was only $1.98, so I figured I'd give it a shot, and I can put stuff on it and make it look spooky still. All right, so I'll leave that out for now. What else have we got? All right, I got this guy from Home Depot. I actually didn't even really notice it when I was shopping in the store. I just happened to be, or I was reading the comments, I always read the comments, and someone had mentioned how cool it was, and I was like, wait, what? And then I went back and I looked at it and I thought it was very cool. They actually have two different versions of this, but they're so very similar. I wanted to get two so I could put them on like both sides of my mantle or something, but again, they look way too similar, and I wanted it to look a little bit differently. But there's the flame effect inside. I think it makes a very cool effect. I love this pumpkin, and it works perfectly with my Headless Horseman living room theme this year. And to go along with that, I got this lantern, just a little decorative lantern. That's not quite Halloween, but for the Headless Horseman, I was kind of trying to do Well, first I wanted to do a lantern theme, and that didn't really turn out. All right, see if I can get my candle to light here. Candle did not come with the lantern. I bought my lantern from Home Goods. It was $29.99, so it's a little pricey, but I actually like the look of it. Doesn't have any glass in it. I just thought it was kind of a cool decorative item, and it went pretty well with my Fleming pumpkin from Home Depot. That was $20. So it makes a nice little vignette when I add my Sleepy Hollow signage to it and a little bit of other decor. I think it looks really good on my entryway table. And if you're part of my Patreon team, you will have seen that already. So I like to kind of give them a bit of heads up what I'm doing. So again, if you want to keep up with my Halloween decorating, keep watching the channel. You'll see it eventually, but probably not till we do our walkthrough of the house, which probably is going to be not till the end of this month or early October. But I do, again, like to keep my patrons updated. All right, let's move on to some other big products. So I got this sign. It's actually a tin sign, and it came from Amazon. It was $16.98, I think, or something like that. And I've already framed it. Basically, this is a frame I keep hanging in my kitchen area. I just took out the back. I flipped over the picture and just taped the tin sign onto the back of the picture. That way it kind of looks like it's a framed picture, and this is kind of like a mat. I mean, if you look closely, you can maybe tell it's it's not, but I think it looks pretty good by itself. If I haven't told you yet, I'm kind of doing a psychic theme in my kitchen. So I thought this sign was perfect for it. And the arrow actually points perfectly. So you're walking from my living room this way, right into my kitchen area, and the little arrow kind of points the way toward the psychic. I thought that was kind of fun. All right. Now, I do like to switch up my artwork in my kitchen, depending on the theme every year. So I bought some fun new posters, and I haven't opened them up yet. Let's go ahead and do that now. Check them out. I actually got three of these posters on eBay. I bought one originally, and then I liked it, the idea of it, I should say, so much that I went ahead and bought two more to fill out the theme. The first, let's see, which one do I want to show you first? I think this middle one, of course, which makes it a little difficult. So here we go. This is a tarot card, and it has the Headless Horseman on it. This, I know it's a little hard to see here. Wow, this is really printed in very high quality, heavy paper. It's not like the other posters I've bought in the past. So I'm kind of happy about that, and especially since these were a bit pricey, they were like $34.95 each. But I thought this was perfect. It has the Headless Horseman that, you know, works in my living room, which I'll hang on the wall going into the kitchen area. And it's a tarot card, so, you know, I'm going to have the other two tarot cards hanging in the kitchen. But since I am not going to use my cinema posters that we put together earlier this year, since I'm not doing my garage haunt this year, I'm going to go ahead and reframe my posters into these frames and see what it looks like. There we go. I love it. It's perfect Headless Horseman artwork that I've been looking for. And again, it fits thematically in both of my kitchen and living room perfectly. So let's go ahead and frame the other ones and see how they turn out. And here we have the Hermit, which is depicting the Grim Reaper on the River Styx. I thought that was very creepy. I love this artwork. It's just cool. So, one to go. And our third one is The Lovers. Again, another Grim Reaper. Really love the artwork. This one's got his face showing with the skeleton wings. It's pretty cool. So these two are going in my kitchen. That, again, the Headless Horseman will be the transition piece. And I cannot wait to see how they look up on the wall. I'm really impressed by the quality of the posters. I bought posters in the past that were much lower price point. I mean, I don't like paying more than like 10 bucks for a poster. And these were way above that. And I splurged on it because it was exactly what I was looking for my design. And I'm not disappointed at all because the quality of the material just feels fantastic and the artwork is great. So very happy with those purchases. But I did in fact get one more poster. This one was slightly less expensive at $29.99. Again, it was a bit more than I like to spend, let's see. And I can already tell that this one is a little bit less quality. While those you could definitely tell had a very heavy paper feel, this one has more of the, it feels like photo paper. I mean, it's a nice quality. But it's not, definitely not as substantial as that. So let me go ahead and frame this one and we'll take a look at it. All right, are you ready? I bought this one simply so I could see Tom's face when he goes into the bathroom. I love it. Your butt napkins, my lord. This might be something I might end up leaving hanging up in my bathroom year round. Obviously, it'll be in my bedroom bathroom so that, you know, nobody's going to see it except us. But I thought it was hilarious and I love it. And, you know, I've never decorated my bathroom before. So now's my chance. I am a little bit more disappointed in the quality of this. There's something about the way they rolled it. They rolled it one way and then like flipped it and rolled it the other so that there's this big wavy crease in the middle. But it's kind of disappeared. I mean, it's not creased. It's just more of, I guess, a foldedness. So I guess that disappears when you frame it. But it was definitely a little disappointing. All right, with the big stuff out of the way, let's go ahead and see what else I got. There's several little things I can't wait to show you, starting with this guy. For my Headless Horseman decor in my living room, it is this little Headless Horseman statue. He does light up. It's kind of odd. I don't like that his on-off switch is... Well, I guess that's good, because it's easy to get to. You don't have to lift him up to put it there. I guess that's all right. Not really thrilled with the way he looks when he's lit up. I just don't need that. I kind of like him just regular, like a little statue. And in fact, all I did is I'm taking a little planter, sticking it upside down, sticking him on top of it. It gives him a little bit more presence, like he's a little statue. So I love him. $16.99 from Home Goods. On the cheaper end, to go with the sort of literary theme of the Headless Horseman, I got these little book boxes. You know, you can probably see them here in the back shelf. I love these book boxes. There's something, I like doing literary themes with my Halloween decorating. These came from the Dollar Tree, so they were only a dollar, little box. And I think for the price point, it's fantastic because the little ones of these are like $8 and then they range up to maybe, I don't know, 15, 16 bucks, maybe even 20, I don't remember. So if I could get these smaller books for a dollar, I'm all over it. And they came in different sizes. So there were four different designs and each design had all different sizes. I think there might've been a fourth size. So I didn't like the one that was a little bit bigger. So I tried to keep it, or was it smaller? I don't remember. But I'm happy with the selection I got. They all have little interesting spines. So no matter how we display it, we can, you know, do something with our books and make it look fun. don't know, something like that. We'll see. But dollar each for the books. Love them. I also got from the Dollar Tree a bunch of skulls. They have these every year, so this is nothing new. But I bought 15 of these originally with my Headless Horseman. I mean, there's just not enough Headless Horseman decor to fill up my living room. So I thought I would kind of fill it in with like woodsy, raveny stuff. But then I decided, I can't really find enough of that either. So I'm just going to do a skull, skeleton type theme. And to expand on that, you may remember 2 years ago, I did a witch theme in my living room. And then last year it was a pumpkin man theme who kind of married the witch and may have killed her. I don't remember. Well, this year I'm expanding on the witch theme just a little bit more. So I'm going to have kind of like the witch decor, and the Headless Horseman has come in and taken over. So I've got my witch cauldrons that I'm going to put on my hearth. And I'm just going to fill them with these skulls. And clearly I definitely bought far too many skulls. I overestimated how many it would take to fill a cauldron. So I thought it would take like 5 at the most. It takes 3 to have overflowingness. So I bought 15 bucks worth, and I probably don't need that many, but I can put them, you know, elsewhere around just to keep my skulls flowing throughout the room. From Walmart, I picked up not one, but 2 of these lanterns, which I'm not really sure now if they're going to suit the purpose I'd intended them for. I probably shouldn't be ripping these off. Maybe I could return them if I don't use them, but I probably won't. I'll keep them. So, got my lantern. It lights up. Be nice if it flickered. Does it flicker? No, not really. It just kind of lights up. But I really love the little skull detail on the top of the lantern. It's very light. I mean, it's not a well-built prop. It was $15. But I bought 2 of them, depending on what I want to do with it. I wasn't quite sure. I was either going to maybe put it on both sides of my mantle, or both sides of a side table, something. I don't know. But I definitely wanted it in 2. I think if I were to put these outside eventually, maybe 1 year, they look great on top of columns. It's a cheap, inexpensive way to do column lighting. All right, from Walmart, I got this City Morgue body drop-off parking only sign to put up outside my driveway area where I've got a little bit of a parking pad next to the road so people could see that. I just thought it was kind of fun. But that's where I'm going to be doing my Ghostbusters theme, so I don't know, it kind of clashes. But we'll see. Maybe not. Maybe the ghosts are coming out of the City Morgue. I guess it kind of works. But I like these tins. They were $3.88. You probably saw them in my last Walmart walkthrough video. They have all sorts of designs. I really like them. So check them out if you're interested. Thought they were pretty high quality. Hopefully, if I put this outside, it's got a very interesting texture. It almost feels kind of like sandpaper. But I'm hoping that the weather doesn't cause that to be any problem. All right, I think this might be, is this the last thing? All right, this might be the last thing, I guess. So I got these from Home Goods for $7.99. I told you I love the books. Well, these are gonna go in the kitchen with my psychic theme. This is the Palmistry Guide. It doesn't open, it's not a box. It's actually kind of a ceramic material. And then to go along with it, this Carpe Noctem, Seize the Night. Just, I needed something to go with it. I couldn't just have one, they only had 2. So there, makes a nice little display to put on my side table. So I think that is all I got this month. I don't see anything else on my floor, but I think that's enough for now. All right, I can't wait to get started decorating. Can't wait to put up my pictures. Stay tuned as we get closer to Halloween, and I'll be definitely doing a walkthrough of all my fun stuff, and hopefully next month we'll do, or at the end of this month, we'll do another thrift store haul if we find anything in the stores. Cross my fingers, but you know, you never know. But there's lots of fun stuff coming out in the stores now, so make sure you stay tuned for all my walkthroughs that I'm doing and for future hauls. So until then, thanks for watching, guys. Take care. happy haunting.